Good evening, y'all. Come on in. Come on in. Where y'all at? We're back. Good evening. Good evening. Come on in. Come on in. We want to see y'all. We want to hear from y'all. We're back.
We're live in the place.
Aloha. Aloha. Sis Connie has pivoted to Facebook, as she oftentimes do. She's covering all bases.
We're back. We're back.
Hi, Brother June.
Where our members at? Y'all getting back?
Y'all come on in.
Kind of cool. From Facebook to
Aloha.
From Zoom to Facebook.
Yes. Y'all come on in. Brother June, this is Maxine. Y'all come on in. As I indicated, Sis Connie. Sis Melissa.
God bless you. God bless you, Brother DiOrio. Sis Maxine Lawless from Lee City, Texas.
Brother DiOrio, yes.
Praise
y'all come
the
on
Lord.
In.
Stella Johnson. What you say, Stella? God bless you.
Hi, Sis Stella.
The boss is on. The boss is Sister Rhonda and Edward
yes.
Brooks.
Hi, Sis. Hey, Bristow.
How you doing?
Girl. Y'all come
Lydia
on
Jones,
in.
Harvey, God bless you.
Yes, hi, Sis.
And Carrie Harvey, yeah. God bless you.
Hi, Sis Marcia Williams.
Let's say Brother Craig Trosclair, the maestro, and Sister Rose, if she's near.
Hi, Brother Craig and Sis Rose.
Sister Mary Ann Winchester, God bless you. I'm sorry I missed that birthday.
Yes, happy belated
celebration,
birthday.
But God bless you, God bless you. I know y'all had a great time.
Hi, Sis Jennifer. Y'all come on in. Good evening. We are back.
Meet you. God bless you. Pray all is well with you and your family. As well.
Y'all come on in. Come on in. A blessed good evening to you all. Aloha. We're still celebrating.
We're still hanging on, just
reflecting on the beautiful memories made. And so just spare us for a moment as we, you know, still want to speak that Hawaii language.
Aloha. Hello and goodbye, huh?
Yes. Stand in need of prayer. We got you, Sis Connie. Y'all come on in. Come on in, Sis Dolores.
Tamika Stevenson,
hi,
God
Tamika.
Bless you. And Brother Stevenson, Ron
yes.
August and his family.
Hi,
God bless
Bertha.
You.
Bertha Joshua.
Is coming on, Sister Shawanda Mumphrey, God bless you. Joseph Nelson, God bless you, Brother Nelson. Sister Buggage, Yvonne Buggage, God bless you.
Y'all come on in, blessed good evening to you as you're joining us. And if you want to be getting your devices together, we're coming from...
Well, you know we close to each other. We got to celebrate one together, Marianne. Gonna be me and your birthday together.
If you want to get your devices and
Minister Kenneth August, God
Bibles
bless you.
Together, we're coming from 1 Peter, the 4th chapter.
1 Peter, we're still in 1 Peter. We're now in the 4th chapter, and our theme tonight is living in the future. We're going to deal with verses 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. It's going to be a great discussion as we deal with how we can live in the future tense as we as believers, of course, being misunderstood, being criticized, ridiculed, and so on and so forth. But how do we respond to those situations?
Yes.
So we're going to teach you and talk about how we can not be victim of it and
yes,
become make decisions that would disgrace us and cause us to be defeated.
Yes, amen, amen. Hi, Tiffany. Thank you for joining on tonight. First lady.
Joanna Jones, God bless you.
Yeah, Brother Craig. Oh, get ready, get ready, get ready. Yes, he's coming with it.
I don't know, man.
Blazing.
I'm good, Craig. I learned how to just say, you know what, I'm going to be, what's the word I'm trying to find?
Hi, Sis Patience.
Sister Audrey Augusta, Sister Adeline Hollis, God bless you
Hollis.
And all. We certainly
Sister
love y'all, miss y'all.
Yes.
We thank y'all for y'all prayers. Your prayer certainly did not go on deaf ear.
Oh,
God
no, it surely
heard
has
it.
Not yet.
He heard the prayer. Sister Val, God bless you.
Hi, Hi, Sister Anna. Thank you. Yeah, we definitely felt the prayers as we travel here
Brother,
and there. And
Merlin just, Williams, God bless you. Homeboy.
And just celebration, you know, just y'all well wishes and best wishes to us. They haven't gone unnoticed. And we so, so appreciate them. You know, as we said, we got to celebrate each other, celebrate one another.
Sister Patient, God bless you, Sister Patient. Pray all is well. Hope all is well with you as well.
Mrs. Bell. Y'all come on in. Blessed good Dawn evening.
Dawn Marie. I don't want to miss
like,
her name.
Like, comment, and share as you're coming
in. God bless
in.
You. Matter of fact, yeah, evangelize. Get an opportunity to like and also share. Pull in somebody else. Call somebody. Let them know that we are on.
And we're
let them
back.
Know that this lesson is for them. This lesson is for all of us because we all need to live in the future.
In the future tense.
And that we are living for God. We're going to go through some things. But how do we continue to maintain our equilibrium? How
Amen.
We continue to maintain the balance God wants us to have?
Hi, Sister Wanda. Thank you.
Sister
so
Wanda,
much.
God bless you. KKAY. I seen Wanda one Sunday on the bus coming in and
she
doing
was
the
right
job.
And being faithful. Hello. Being
you said from the fair city of Donaldsonville,
yes.
But she was traveling.
But
this is your voice,
yeah.
The angel of faith.
Hi, the Taylor family from
so
Lafayette, Louisiana.
For our third Sunday, of course, men, get y'all pink together. We're going to pink it out.
Pink it out.
No pink suit,
more,
man.
More.
No pink suit, please. Nobody going to be looking like no pink panther. Okay, well, where your pink pants? You can get your pink suit off, Craig. Go ahead on. You can have your pink.
Well, you will not see Craig in a pink suit. I think I can say that boldly. Oh, my God. Hey, our evangelist has checked in.
Evangelist
yes,
is in the house. Yes. God bless you, Sister Evangelist. Praise the Lord. You just provoked it and really caused the prayer on Monday night just to get us into God's presence with not just asking Him anything, but just want to thank Him.
Amen.
And praise the Lord. And we thank God for your testimony. And of course, God, He has delivered you. He has healed you. And He did it not just for you to hold on to it, but to let others know that He is a miracle working God.
Oh, yes.
He's still doing it.
He's still faithful. He's still in the miracle working business.
He's still astounding
he's
the
still
minds.
Else his
even
prayers.
Of those who are in the doctors and those who have went through the advanced technology
said, this
and
is
study.
The first season. All right, yep. Girl. You better speak that boldly.
Hallelujah. Happy birthday, Sister Tiffany Robinson, if you're home. God
yes.
bless you. Rick
happy
Williams.
Birthday, and happy anniversary to the both
man,
of you.
Man. Yeah, matter of fact, they're celebrating their, what, I think it was, I don't want to quote their number.
I
yeah,
I've
seen a number, but,
happy
but yeah, but happy anniversary and happy birthday.
Yes.
And of course, Laquita Williams, God
Hi,
bless you, who
Laquita,
we certainly have to get with you and Leroy, as we want to make
y'all
sure y'all feel welcome and
yes.
and begin to get y'all in alignment and accustomed to the Emmanuel family. Mm-hmm. Certainly, we certainly welcome y'all and we certainly will
Amen.
Be reaching out. To you.
And hello to all who are joining us via Zoom. I think I got Sis Bernice. Good evening to you. Aloha.
Aloha.
And to all who are joining us on this evening. We are back and we want you all to get back into just diving into His Word. You know, we've been on this journey of triumphant living. So
praise the Lord.
21 years.
I got you. 21. Happy
21 years
of marriage to grace. God bless you. I'm telling you, the more you love God, the more you love God, the more you love each other.
Yes.
And I'm telling you, it's almost like, you know what? You don't never come out of the honeymoon.
Yeah. Yes.
30 years, and it's like we just got married, you know, and our love has never ceased to grow. We have grown in our relationship with God.
Amen.
And we have grown in our relationship with one another.
Amen.
So,
amen.
And, happy wife, happy husband, happy life.
Amen. Amen. And it holds true. I mean, you know, I can attest to that fact. It holds true to it. And none that I take for granted. And that's the crux of it all. That we never get to the point where we're taking each other for granted. And we just honoring each other is in the spirit of what God requires it to be. The spirit of true love, true respect one to another. and just honoring, you know, what he ordained. And so we are grateful and thankful for you all and your best wishes to us and just celebrating us. And you know, when you celebrate us, you're celebrating yourself.
You're celebrating, and that's what you know, one of the things we learned in Hawaii, and as we were walking the street, and we were twinning just about
such
every day.
Such gracious people.
And
such,
people were just, wow, friendly. Look at y'all outfit. It's so nice, huh? I mean, we just picked these up. But it was just people, you know, celebrated us and just wishing us well. And 30 years, we wore our 30-year anniversary shirt. And we just got to get to the place of learning how to celebrate each other.
Yeah, amen.
Thank God for what He's doing in the life of other people. Yes. You know, and
if you're genuine, if you're genuine and all, and God gives us discernment. He gives you discernment, and Our culture has shifted.
So yeah. When one got out, we celebrated because we knew that they were coming back to help us get out of our situation. Yes. And so we got to begin to start changing the mind of how we really think. You know, we were strong, bear them from it. We rejoice with them who rejoice.
Amen.
We celebrate with them that we celebrate. Yes. We so often don't mind mourning with them that are mourning when they're going through. I'm praying for your brother, but when you're doing well, they have a tendency. We got an issue. But no, we got to do better than that. And if we expect better, we got to do better.
Amen.
You know, always know God operates on a law that whatever a person sows, that's what he reaps. And so I learned that if I want a blessing, I have to learn how to be a blessing.
Amen.
Give a blessing.
Has his roof. Come on in.
That's Ruth Harris.
That's Ruth Harris.
How you doing, Ruth Harris? I haven't heard from her in a while. I thought she had abandoned us or something.
Amen.
I don't know what was going on.
And your son Jimmy, JJ.
My son didn't check in? Okay.
He didn't check in.
I don't have no child support this morning, Jimmy.
Amen.
Coach Joseph.
Hey, T. Liz, I think we didn't catch T. Liz.
Oh, how you doing, T. Liz? God bless you.
Sister Valentine, I'm kind of going back while the pastor was.
I said Sister Valentine. Oh, okay. She don't know. I'm on my stuff.
My brother Darcy and Sister.
I'm on my stuff,
Sister
Valentine. And then I seen her, yesterday at Walmart.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. She was talking up to, oh no, I got to go holler at my pastor. I'll see y'all later.
So as y'all come in, y'all like, comment, and share. We're going to go ahead and get things started. Blessed, glorious evening. Aloha to each and every one of you all. We are back, and we are so humbly grateful to have each and every one of you all to just be so faithful as you join in with us as we open up God's Word, as we've been on this journey of triumphant living. We're on lesson 9, I think it is. We're in counting. And we hope that these lessons, as we oftentimes exclaim, has been one that has been enriching, enlightening to you all. In fact, as I think about enlightenment, y'all may see us wearing our little kakui nuts. We were blessed with these by Sister Rose. But they are very popular in Hawaii. And the symbolicness of them is it speaks of enlightenment. Protection, guidance, and peace. And we find that to be so enriching, which was the crux of our getaway. We really sold into the very essence of that. And again, we're so humbly grateful to be back. We're so thankful for the many, many prayers that went up for us on our behalf, for traveling grace, and just for enjoying this getaway. And as we had the song playing, "You Ain't Seen Nothing Yet, The Best Is Yet to Come." But again, we're so grateful to have you in again with us on our Bible study table talk. Of course, you know we bring you greetings from New Emmanuel Baptist Church, where we love the Lord.
We love each other and we love the lost.
We are growing and flowing in love, and we are a church that is Christ-centered, Bible-based, and family-focused. And of course, you know we've been on this journey in 1 Peter. So if you want to turn your attention to 1 Peter, we're coming from the 4th chapter. And we're going to cover verses 1 through 6.
Yes, ma'am.
But just for the sake of just opening up in the sake of time, I'm just going to open up with verse 1. Again, that's 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 1. For as much then as Christ has suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourselves likewise with the same mind, for he that had suffered in the flesh had ceased from sin. I just read 1 Peter, the 4th chapter, verse 1. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, the hearing, and the doing of his holy word. And again, as you know, we've been on this journey, this series of triumphant living. Our theme on tonight is living in the future tense. Living in the future tense. But before we dive into the lesson, we're going to ask that the pastor opens up with prayer.
Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father in heaven, we come today in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
God, we come with humble and grateful heart,
yes,
my God. Come into your presence, God. Just want to thank you again.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for this day, God, for your mercy and for your grace.
Yes.
Thank you, God, for providing for us and protecting
yes,
us and giving
God.
Us everything that we need that yes. is pertaining to life and godliness. And God, we certainly thank you for this privilege and opportunity
you
afford
yes.
us,
thank
Lord God,
Lord.
To come into fellowship with you
Hallelujah.
And with one another. And Father God, as we just think about our theme tonight, to live in the future tense. And as we wear these necklaces, Lord God, a symbol of enlightenment. God, we need enlightenment, Lord God. We ask you to help us to the present power of
yes.
your Holy Spirit. And as we bring forth this word tonight, God, that you open up our understanding, that you truly will enlighten us, Lord God, so that we can live even today, Lord God,
yes, God.
In the future tense. So that we can live, Lord God, not a defeated life, not a disgraced life,
oh,
Lord
yes.
God, but a life of victory.
Yes.
Because we know, God, Christ already gave us victory at Calvary. And Christ has already caused us to triumph and make manifest his saving knowledge in every place. So wherever we may be at tonight, Lord God, whatever our situation is, God, we believe tonight, Lord God, because someone has came in, it's not a accident,
yes.
but God, it's a divine appointment
Hallelujah.
For them to hear what thus says the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Now, God, we come and we decrease, we ask that you would increase, speak to us, speak through us, and speak for us. Anoint our lips of clay, Lord
yes,
God, that as we speak
yes.
and teach today,
yes,
we would do
God.
It in the oracles of God. And as we minister, I pray that we would do it in the ability
yes,
that you would be glorified. Open up every eyes
Please,
that they
Lord.
Might see. Open
yes.
up their ear that they might hear.
Yes.
And every heart that they might be receptive.
Hallelujah,
now, God, let this word go forward as a living
yes,
seed.
God.
Yeah, God, let it go forward on good soil, that
oh,
it will produce
yes.
a harvest. 30, 60, 100-fold. And God, we are mindful to give you all praise, all glory, and honor. We ask it all in the
yes.
mighty, marvelous, magnificent name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
And if
amen.
You redeemed today,
amen.
Why don't you just tap amen. Come on,
amen.
Type amen,
amen
on that.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Living in the future tense. And again, we're still on our series of triumphant living.
Hallelujah.
Journey to triumphant living.
Praise the Lord. Again, the theme in itself, to live in the future, we know we past, present, and future. And
yes.
oftentimes, many of us can't even live in the present
Come on now.
Because we are so still stuck in the
yeah.
past. And a
oh.
lot of times, things happen to us in the past
yeah.
hinder us from moving and even
forward.
Thinking about
yeah.
the future.
Yeah.
But God says if we're going to become victors and not victim, if we're going to live the victorious life that God has given us, we especially in this life have to learn how to live in the future tense.
Yeah.
Of course, we're living in a world today, we're going to always face temptation.
Yeah.
We're going to be bombarded by temptation,
mm-hmm.
whether it's by our friends, whether it's by social media,
yes.
Even in our own sinful lust
mm-hmm.
desire.
Mm-hmm.
And because we are a Christian and because we are living the life of a Christian, Christ-like,
yes.
one of the things that's going to happen is we're going to often be misunderstood.
Yeah.
People are not going to understand some of the decisions
yeah.
you make. And our misunderstanding, especially because from unbelievers,
yes.
We're going to find ourselves being ridiculed.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to find ourselves being persecuted.
Yes.
We're going to find ourselves being criticized.
Mm.
But in the midst of all of that, how can we live a triumphant life?
Mm-hmm.
How can we live a victorious
yes.
life? The way we do it is we have to learn how to live in the future tense. And so verse 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 is going to give us an outline. Let me give it to you. The first thing we're going to talk about
mm-hmm.
is attitudes.
Yes.
Our attitudes.
You know, we discussed that before.
Our attitude is so part, and it's imperative that if we're going to live future tense, we have to have the right attitude. The second thing, and that's in verse 2, we got to have the right ambition. We got to have the right goals. We have to have the right desire and the right will. Yes. And then verse 3 and 4, we have to have the right action. You know, every action comes a reaction. And we have to know how to act when things come up against us. Of course, and because our action.
Proper attitude.
And that attitude will determine that action. And then finally, that anticipation. What am I living for? Because I'm living my life today that I might live again. And I already know that regardless of what I may be going through now, it can be compared to what God has for me in the future.
Amen.
And so that's what we're going to be at tonight, Sister Brown. Living in the future tense.
Always having a long-term mindset. Don't get stuck so much on your short-term. But even in things and as we approach situations in life, kind of think, sit back and think about the long term. What effect is it going to have on me in the long term?
Praise the Lord. And one of the things that we do as we walk with God in our daily walk with God, one of the things the enemy wants us to do is to go without a vision. If I don't have a vision about my future, then the Bible said without a vision, the people
perish.
And so what happened is he don't want you to see. And so again, we need to be enlightened about the future. Of course, it's an enlightenment. And so now once I'm enlightened, guess what? I can begin to be protected by whatever is kind of come up against me. And even in my protection, I can have my guidance. I can walk through the valley. Because I see something. Guess what? Because in the future, he already prepared a table before me.
That's
while I'm going through this, I can have peace about it. Instead of me coming falling apart, I can do what? And so that's why we got these necklaces on, y'all.
Come on,
let's go ahead, Sister Brown.
Okay, living in the future tense. And of course, we're covering 1 Peter, the 4th chapter, verse 1 through 6. You want me to just go right into the thing? So, God in this present world is living in the future tense, which has at least 4 requirements, as the pastor indicated. Number 1. The right attitude.
Now read first. We're going to read verse 1 and then
read
verse 1 and then Sister Brown is going to read throughout, and if I have to say anything, I'll say it. Y'all know I'm already fired up, right? But I'm going to let verse 1 in Peter.
First Peter chapter 4 verse 1. For as much then as Christ has suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourselves likewise with the same mind. For he that hath suffered in the flesh hath ceased from sin.
Now, listen, I'm going to let her read it because there's a lot of meat there. But I'm going to let her read it over there, and then I'll just jump in when I have to.
Peter has just written about Christ suffering in the previous passage. Now, he calls us to follow his example by writing, since therefore Jesus suffered in the flesh, arm yourselves. The word translated arm is a military term that refers to arming with weapons. What is our best weapon in this world? It is the same way of thinking as Christ. How does Paul express this in Philippians 2 and 5?
So I'm going to expound right quick. Of course, now he's talking about going in verse 1 again. Arming ourselves and having the same mind of Christ. And so when we're talking about the arming, the military thing, we got to know when you talk about arming ourselves in the mind, the battle now is in our mind. And what the enemy wants to do is try to get in our head. And so when believers were going through persecution, going through the ridicule, being put down, just tearing them up, he said, wait a minute, you got to arm yourself in your mind. And that's what Paul says in Philippians, let this mind be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus. Of course, in Proverbs it says, so a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Of course, in Isaiah chapter 26, I got to give it to you. He says, thou will give us perfect peace if our mind
is stayed on.
And so Paul says in Philippians chapter 4, verse 8, I'm just giving it to you because this is what I'm telling you. We got to make sure that our mind is armed up. And you have to arm your mind through the word of God. He said, finally, my brother, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, in a virtue, in a praise. Get what he said. Take on these
stand. So my question tonight is, what are you thinking about? Are you thinking about what people saying about you? Oh. Are you thinking about them persecute? What are you? And sometimes we get so caught up with what other people.
Come on.
And so we start the stinking thinking. Yes. But no, we have to begin to start thinking about, we have to have a mind of Christ.
Amen, amen, amen. And we got to realize that it's nothing but the enemy that is trying to derail us when we get caught up in people who are not even qualified to talk about you.
Come on.
Especially when you live in the life that is pleasing to God and you got ungodly people trying to, what, paint a narrative about you that is not true. And then you allow yourself to go down that rabbit hole in your thinking, in your mind, because you know you have anxiety about that.
And
have to be delivered
from that. And that's where deliverance comes through army. He said, I'm building up my mind. And so, because if I fill my mind up with the word of God, then I'm not even thinking about what they're saying. Because I'm being renewed by the spirit
of
my mind.
Said.
Right. And so, and I stand on what God said.
Yes.
Too often we're trying to get the affirmation and the approval of man. And we have to make sure and stop trying to fit in where you don't belong. Stop trying to force a square hole in a circle.
Mm-hmm.
God said you don't belong there. You're not growing that. And it's time for you to move, and you can't grow in that situation.
Mm-hmm.
And so don't try to compromise in areas where you know it's not godly.
Mm-hmm.
Because unbelievers are not going to understand you.
Amen. And you can disconnect in a righteous way, in a respectful way, you know, with the right attitude.
And that's the attitude.
When we are mistreated, the most powerful weapon we have is the mind or attitude of Christ.
Mm.
Wrong attitudes lead to wrong reactions. And we've all been, you know, guilty of it. Which result in defeat and disgrace. However, the right attitude or way of thinking during tough times leads to triumphant living. One reason Christians suffer is for whomever has suffered in the flesh has ceased from sin. This doesn't mean that suffering cleanses us from sin. Only Christ's blood can do that.
Mm-hmm.
But it does mean that obeying God becomes the most important thing in our lives, even if it results in suffering.
Praise
Living
the Lord.
In the future tense requires the right attitude.
So the right attitude. And so I'm not going to go over it, but the first thing that Jesus taught on the Sermon on the Mount was the Beatitudes.
Come on. The attitudes to be.
That, you got it. She's been around here long enough now.
Oh, yes.
He said the Beatitudes are the attitudes to be. And this is the attitude we have to have.
Yes.
Our attitude will determine our altitude. But it based on our aptitude, our ability to learn.
Yes.
And what the enemy don't want you to do is he don't want you.
Mm-hmm.
He wants you to drink yourself and drown yourself in sorrow. And when I begin to start hearing what God said, then now all of a sudden I have the right attitude.
Yes.
And I can begin to start, even what you're dealing with, I can learn how to rise above what's going on presently.
Amen, amen, amen. That's confirmation of a discussion I was having with somebody about just situation and issues and challenges they're finding themselves in. And it's pretty much just telling them, you know, it's predicated on how you choose to manage it, how you choose to reflect yourself, even as you're going through the rough parts, the challenges. How do you show up? How are you showing up trusting in God to carry you through it?
Praise the Lord.
And it's all in the attitude. And so as we living in the future tense requires the right attitude, guess what else it requires?
Mm.
The right ambition.
The right ambition. Verse number 2.
And that's covering verse 2. So verse 2, that he no longer should live the rest of his time in the flesh to the lust of men, but to the will of God.
Amen. Y'all see the choice? Don't live for your own sinful lust desire. But for the will of God. And Sister Brown, you're going to pray. But we pray, not my will.
But
let thy will. And so when we talk about delighting ourselves in the Lord, he give us the desire. The reason why he give us the desires of our
because
heart, because our desire become his will. And his will is based on his word. See, some of us, we want stuff from God and it's not even based on his word. It's not even his will for your life. And so now you're thinking that, you know, I'm the light, I'm quoting scripture.
Yeah.
But are we aligning up with the will of God?
That's the key.
He said, you know, don't live for yourself no more, but live according to God. And so my right ambition, what are your goals? Uh-huh. What are your desires? And then God, I'll let you know whether or not you're living in the future tense.
Yes.
Because I want to live my life that I might live again.
Yeah.
And so when God put me into this earth realm, God ain't put me here to gain again, again. No, God said, no, what are you laying up where your treasures at? Go ahead on.
Yeah. So this means we live for the rest of the time in the flesh, no longer for human passion.
Mm.
But for the will of God. The phrase time in the flesh refers to our lifetime on earth. Our time here is limited by God. How does Job 14:5 express that very fact? Did you want to expound on that?
Yeah, Job 14:5, y'all want to get that scripture?
Yeah.
Because it tells y'all, really, our time is in God's hand.
Come on.
I'm telling you, our time is in God. Job, it says, seeing his days are determined. His days are determined. The number of his month are with thee. Our days are determined. God knows our month.
Mm-hmm.
Thou has appointed bonds.
That bond is
that
fixed.
Cannot be passed.
Come on.
You can't pass it. He got the days. He got the month. Yes. The bond is already set. And so God already knows. And so if God knows when my time is up, then what am I doing? What am I doing with
what
the time that God has given me?
Come on.
What am I doing with the treasure that God has given? What am I doing with the talent that God has given? You know, we talented, we got all that, we do it. But when we using it for worldly gains.
My God.
But God says, I've given it to you. What are you doing
for
as it relates to the advance of my kingdom?
Mm-hmm. How are you investing it?
Mm.
You know. What are you, how are you making the investment so that you can have that greater return?
Hallelujah.
Knowing what that return is, where the reward lies. Because this is just temporal.
Praise the Lord. Uh-huh. So, that's right. So, our time is in God's hand. That's what. So, and it's a temporal thing, but God has blessed us with the time. So, let's give God, let's give God a portion of what he desired and deserved from us.
Our time on earth is limited. Therefore, we shouldn't live for human passions, but for the will of God. Before coming to Christ, we lived to fulfill human passions. But now, our greatest ambition should be to fulfill the will of God for our lives. We know God's general or moral will for all Christians is to refrain from sin. However, how can we find God's specific will for our lives? In Romans 12:2, Paul writes that we are not to conform to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of our minds. Then, what does he write in the rest of that verse? Did you want to
explain? Yeah, no, let me tell you something. That particular verse, it just took on a new thing for me as I was just sharing with my son the other day. I was telling him, you know, a lot of times people tell you to look in the mirror.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell them, I say, no, what we need to do is look out the window.
Ah.
And when you look out the window, what you see, you see the world.
Mm-hmm.
And then after looking at the world, out the window in the world, mm-hmm. then look in the window.
In the mirror.
And then looking at yourself, mm-hmm. are you reflecting mm-hmm. what's on the outside?
Mm-hmm.
Or are you reflecting the image of Christ?
Mm-hmm.
And see, because the word now becomes our mirror.
Yeah.
The word now becomes the thing that we ought to begin to reflect.
Yes.
Paul said, be not conformed, but be transformed.
Yeah,
and many times we're trying to become like the world,
live
like the world.
Uh-huh.
Then we're trying to come in the church and try to bring the church and the world in the church.
Mm-hmm.
But he said, no, be renewed by the spirit of your mind. And the way you'll be renewed by the spirit of your mind is through the word of God.
Mm-hmm.
And so what God, when God saved us, let me just say this, when God saved us, And we were marred, we were damaged, of course, Jeremiah, but he put us back on that wheel and saw that, and he started making us again, because God wants to make us a vessel of honor. We are made in the image of God. We fearfully, wonderfully made. We are made. But okay, the thing is, where is the image?
Yes.
You're looking at the window, and if you're looking at doing the same thing in the world, then it's time to make some changes.
Ah.
There is a transformation that needs to take place, a change, but it has to be based on the Spirit of God and the Word of God.
And we can't draw those we're trying to reach. They're not seeing no difference in it. It's like, they say, well, why do I have to do this? Because there's nothing different about you. There's nothing peculiar about you. You know,
no difference.
We're not setting apart. We're not really representing God in the manner in which He has desired and requires us to do.
We are
because
visible.
We've lost track.
We lost our image.
The image.
And that's what happened. It got tarnished in the garden.
We've
but now God says He pulled us, He saved us. But now we go through what is called sanctification.
Yes.
The Holy Spirit not only convicts us, but the Holy Spirit now is at work in our life to bring us into the conforming in the ways of Christ. But the Holy Spirit can't work with us if we don't ever get in the Word of God. And we don't ever obey God. And we don't have the devotion, the prayer, and all those things that come as a result. It's not what I wear. God is not impressed on what we have on the outside. God knows our heart.
He
and our
heart
needs to begin to reflect the image. So what? So when whatever come out of a man's heart, you know, when you start seeing whatever come out of a man's mouth, that's come from his heart. So what coming out of you is a reflection of what's in you.
Amen. Amen. So the first step in finding God's will is refusing to conform to this world. As we refuse to conform, God will reveal more and more of His will for our lives, one step at a time.
One step.
A process. It is a process, and we have to be mindful how we allow the enemy to creep in. And he creeps in little increments. And before you know it, you get to a certain place, and you have to look around and wonder, how did I get to this point, and how did I lose my way? Because I fell out of the will of God, or I found myself conforming or compromising to what to fit in. And that's the pastor said, to fit into where? Somewhere you wasn't supposed to belong to begin with. So we have to... we have to always stay vigilant in how we're portraying or how we're representing God and His and in His will. As someone has said, the way to see far ahead in the will of God is to go as far
as you can see
ahead as you can see. That is part of what it means to live in the future tense, which begins with the right attitude and having the right ambition.
Come on, that not my will, His
God's will.
Not my wishes, but His wishes, His desire for my life. And
Amen.
So when I begin to do that, I already know that, you know what, sometime God will allow us to go through something to get to something.
And all of us.
And,
yeah.
and of course, but I know
with
His wishes and what His desire for me. So the persecution, the ridicule, and all of that stuff that does come as a result of it, I can still rejoice because I already know I'm in His will, and as long as I'm in His will, I know it's gonna work out for my good. It may not feel good, may not look good, but that's where you know.
Working it out.
Verse 28 and 20. We often read verse 28 in Romans, but we don't read verse 29. Whom He predestined, He also called to be conformed in His image, that we might be firstborn among many brethren. In whom He predestined, He called, and those He called, He justified, and those He justified, He glorified. But in the midst of all that is a sanctification. It's a process.
Yeah.
The glory is at the end result. So I already know I'm living in the future.
Uh-huh.
And so even as I'm going through it, I'm not there yet.
Come on.
But God is still working on me.
It's a continuous work. So just like we have to have the right attitude and the right ambition, now we have to have the right action. We got to put this into action. We got to make
come
it
on,
applicable.
Come on. Applicable.
Okay?
Come
so
on.
Let's come in verses 3 and 4. For the time past of our life may suffice us to have wrought the will of the Gentiles when we walk in the libidinousness, lust, excessive wine, revelings, banquetings, I'm sorry, and abominable idolatries, wherein they think it strange that ye run not with them to the same excess of riot, speaking evil of you.
Praise the Lord. Listen, all of this is lasciviousness, is wild game, sexual unrestrained sex, is having parties, is doing all of this kind of stuff, and you're not a part of it. But
part
you walked away from it. And they're making you feel bad.
Yeah.
As if
this
wait a minute.
You weird.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh
you weird because you're not a but guess what? if I'm going to live in the future tense, mm-hmm. I got to make sure I have the right action.
Yeah.
And some of the stuff that it would name here, mm-hmm. if you go back and read and study it, mm-hmm. you will begin to know that that's not what God mm-hmm. requiring of us. Mm-hmm. The Bible says, come from among them yeah. and be separate. Let me just give y'all one thing on our trip. One thing that was on our trip when we was doing the circuit tour. Yeah. And while we was on a circuit tour, mm-hmm. We was on the bus. You remember mm-hmm. we was on the bus? Mm-hmm. And while we was on the bus, there was a must. I got to say it. It was a must. And Renee was like, oh, my God. She was like, oh, my God. My husband is really, my God. He made his birthday.
At first I was saying,
oh, my God. My husband is really smelling like
extra.
He's okay. really smelling like Hum Dingham. And so there was her. It was a rotten smell. And then I'm smelling myself. I'm like, wait a minute. What in the world am I doing? I ain't never smelled like this before. So we going. And all of a sudden, she was away from me. And then she said, wait a minute. That's me. She thought it was her. But then all of a sudden, began to realize there was a couple that was next to us. And all of a sudden, what happened? What I'm trying to say is, while we were sitting there, we thought it was us.
Yeah.
When we are close to stuff, we begin to start stinking it. Yeah. And that's why we got to start pulling up. That might say, I'm sorry. I had to pull his
wow.
I had to pull his gun. You can fit it. You can't walk in the counsel of ungodly.
Yeah.
God tells us we started stinking. I'm telling you, man, they're like, my God, this man, come, we out here start stinking.
Wow. And that's true. You know, it's like, that's a good analogy because it's amazing how you could, you know, your mind can shift. Your thoughts can shift. You know it's not you, but because it's around you. Mm. You begin to think
it is you.
It is you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Your mind changes.
Come on, bring it in, sister.
And change your way of thinking. Change your knowing, your knowledge, your what you know to be. Oftentimes, if you don't watch it, you give in to what is present.
Come on, that's why we got to separate. Yes. We got praise God. Listen, we just explained that verse there for you. We're going to move to the next one. Anything else on there, Sister Brown? Did you thought it was me,
at
right?
At first, because it was every time we would get off of the bus, and I'm right behind Charles, I said, well, I've never in all of my years, Charles has never, ever, you know, he called himself, he said he was Hum Dingham. I never knew him as that. And it was like, oh, when they came all the way to Hawaii, you mean to tell me he never got to put on deodorant? But at any rate.
So verse 4 says, look, when you talk about in the time past, we used to do that kind of stuff. That stuff mm-hmm. among Gentiles. Yeah. We walk in lasciviousness and lust and excessive wine. We drink, raveling. Man, that's partying. That's mm-hmm. orgying and all that. That's banqueting and party here and party there. Abomination, adulteries. We did all of that. Mm-hmm. He said, this thing wherein they think you strange. Why? Because you run out with them no more. You mm-hmm. don't hear. Well, yeah, homie. Well, yeah, brother. Where you going? Mm-hmm. Hey, man, I ain't got time for that.
Right.
To the same excess arise. Now they what? Speaking evil you.
Yeah.
Man, y'all that dude weird.
It's a maritime ship. Yeah. It's a maritime ship where now they're telling you weird.
Yeah, you weird because you don't.
You living according to the will of God. You living to please God. You living to make God smile.
Come on, action.
And they're telling you there's something wrong with you.
Come on.
Because you're not you're not doing what's popular, what's happening, or so, you know, what's worldly. And oftentimes especially our young kids, they buy into that because oftentimes they're seeking to want to belong. Mm-hmm. They want to be accepted. And what they oftentimes do,
they
peer pressure. They give into what the world or their peers are telling them. It's popular. It makes you,
And that's why when we baptize our kids, when we put our kids in church, it is imperative that we tell our kids to make sure that you're reading, that you're getting under the word.
Yeah.
Because Daniel and the lion den, it was more than just about Daniel and the lion den, the three Hebrew boys. Mm-hmm. they were brought over there as teenagers. Mm-hmm. And they had to literally adapt to the culture and everything else. Mm-hmm. But they refused that.
Right.
Even in that environment, they refused it. Because they would rather serve God. Yeah. And they were more fair than all of those. Mm-hmm. And so what the enemy wants you to do, take drugs, take alcohol. Yeah. Because everybody else is doing it. Mm-hmm. But the ones who don't, they staying out and they staying up and God lift them up and raise
God
them up out of it.
You gotta
irregardless, you gotta have the right action. Right action. Mm-hmm. Right attitudes, right ambition, and the right action.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm thinking about my future. Mm-hmm. What am I expecting? Yeah. Acceptance.
Exactly. And so as we're we know that our future tense requires right attitude, right ambition, right action. Lastly, the right anticipation. Of course, that's covering verses 5 and 6. And I'm going to read them quickly because I know we're
pretty much out of time. Yeah.
Who shall give account to him that is ready to judge the quick and the dead? For this cause was the gospel preached also to them that are dead, that they might be judged according to men in the flesh, but live according to God
in the spirit. Praise the Lord. So that's a whole lot again about just having the right anticipation. What are we anticipating? What are we expecting as it relates to our future? Mm-hmm. And so one of the things we got to do is we have to be mindful of the fact that we don't get to the place of compromising and begin to walk in out of alignment with God.
Yeah.
And now all of a sudden, Noah, he preached in 120 years, and people were laughing at Noah.
Yeah.
They were laughing at him. And so when the storm and when the rain came,
crazy.
They were locked out, and they couldn't get in.
Weird,
and we can't miss out on what we're expecting God, what we're anticipating from God. And so we got to know, we got to stand before the judgment seat of God.
For ourselves.
And we have to do what? Give an account.
Yes.
Of our stewardship. We have to do it. And of course, Christ, the gospel, will preach to those that were dead. Y'all remember in Ephesians, he talking about when he ascended on high, descended, went to the lower part, and he led the captivity captive.
Mm-hmm.
So he preached to that they would be judged according to the flesh. And sometimes we get judged by people. Sometimes people put us down and all that. And it's all right to be judged by people. I would rather be judged by people than stand before God judgment seat because why did that? Because I'm compromising with the world.
Mm-hmm.
Don't worry about that because we have to continue to stay engaged in the Spirit of God.
Amen.
Continue to be led by the Spirit of God.
Mm-hmm. And anticipate just what those consequences will be if we are outside of his will. If we continue to want to conform and compromise against his word, against the will of God, we know that there are consequences. We know that, and even in that, we got to know our rightful place when we are in spiritual alignment with God. Don't again, let others take us away or pull us away or pull us down this rabbit hole and change our way of thinking and knowing that we are on the right side of that great reward.
We stand
in truth. We stand on God's promises. We stand on his word.
Amen. And certainly we know that this earth is not our home.
Mm-hmm.
And we have to stand before God.
Of us are faced with temptations on a daily.
And on, I think it's in Matthew 12:36, it says, and all of us, are going to give account. Every idle word that we speak, we shall give an account unto God. Because by your words, you're justified, and by your words, you're condemned.
Mm-hmm.
And so we have to be mindful even what we're speaking out of our mouth.
Yeah.
Because we're going to have to stand before God, and we have to give an account unto God.
Yeah.
And so I'm anticipating, I'm expecting something great from God, because I want to have the right attitude toward God.
Yeah.
I want to have the right attitude toward the saints of God.
Yeah.
And I want to have the right attitude toward sinners.
Amen.
Even those who persecute me, he tells us what to do.
Yeah.
Bless them that curse you. Do good to the hater.
Yes.
Pray for them that despitefully misuse you.
It.
If your enemy hungry, get what you do.
Feed them.
If he thirsty,
do what? Give him to drink.
Matter of fact, he said you're going to heap coals of fire. You got to confuse the enemy.
Yes.
And you don't confuse the enemy by going tit for tat.
That's
you confuse him by saying, you know what?
Yeah.
Giving them, you don't keep, love don't keep record telling them right or wrong.
Hallelujah.
Sometimes you just have to take the Lord word and say, you know what? Go ahead on. Mm-hmm. You know, even when I'm right. Yes. Because it's about salvation of lost people.
Hallelujah.
The law, and so we and we love them.
Yes.
Even I don't it's not a person in this earth. Mm-hmm. Not one person, mm-hmm. I don't care what they may say. I want to see everybody I come in contact, even my enemy, mm-hmm. get to the place of knowing God.
Knowing them.
I don't want my action. I don't want my attitude. So I don't want my selfishness mm-hmm. or my action mm-hmm. make them miss out on who God is.
Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. And guess what? We will be held accountable. Because of the position that we've taken in identifying with Christ. And if we're leading people down the wrong way, if we're being a stumbling block to them, guess what? God is holding us accountable to it. So, and as I've oftentimes say, the older I'm getting, my eyes is all the more fixed on making it in. So I'm going to do my level best. Look, we don't always get it right. That's why we have to crucify flesh every day. We say that oftentimes in our lessons. We have to crucify flesh every day to make sure that we are in right relationship. We're keeping ourselves in spiritual alignment.
Hallelujah.
And that comes through reading His Word, renewing ourselves with His Word, and staying in prayer for Him to help us, to guide us, to protect us, because we can't do it of our own. None of us are perfect, but we're striving for perfection. And it's time out to keep making excuses about, well, the devil made me do it. And you're constantly in that sin. You're not learning from it. We make mistakes. You know, we make mistakes. We stumble, we fall, short. But then it's your choice to pick yourself up.
Hallelujah.
And to want to get it right. God grants us new mercies each and every day to get it right. He said, okay, I'm giving you another chance. Right. I'm giving you another day. Get it right. Stop making excuses. Stop putting it off. Make it right with yourself and with others that you know that you need to make it right with.
Praise the Lord.
That's across the spectrum.
Now here's the analogy, Sister Brown, mm-hmm. I want to give. Yeah. Of course, as a child, I remember my kids coming up, and one of the things was always a joy as a father mm-hmm. is to teach them different things. And one of the things we used to do is when we taught them how to ride a bike.
Yeah.
And riding bikes, they had training wheels
training
on them
wheels.
Bikes.
Uh-huh.
And we went from training wheel to one training wheel and to all of a sudden letting them go.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, our kids knew that when we were pushing them and mm-hmm. they knew we was there.
Right
whenever
there.
They would fall, they know we were what? Yeah. We'll get them up. And so you might have training wheels on.
Yeah.
You might have one wheel on.
Well,
but soon enough, it's time for the father to let go and you begin to start moving. Start
and
maturing
and
living a crucified life.
Yeah.
You say it's so important
mm-hmm.
To live a crucified life. When he said, pick up a cross.
Come on.
He, if any man desire to come after me, he didn't say, come and get a house.
Yeah.
Come and get a car.
Come on.
Come and get a whole lot of money. He said, take up a cross. So to take up a cross is to say, I am going to suffer.
Yeah.
In order, in our covenant,
mm-hmm.
We are bleeding to meet one need.
Come on.
But now hold up. Mm. We're in covenant with one another.
Yes.
And we have to suffer in order for somebody else to get to know Christ.
My God.
And so we have to bless the haters.
We sing that
do
song.
Good to them. Listen, it's still about winning souls for Christ. And we're living in the future tense.
Yes. Eternal life. So again, we hope you all have been blessed. I know we're over time. But you know, we had to make up for the time in which we've been away. But even while we were away, we trust that you all have been dutifully in your word and really diving in to stay in spiritual alignment. Again, we can't do it of our own. We need Christ every second, every minute, every hour of the day to keep us on track, to give us the guidance, to give us the protection, to really help us to have that mindset of living in future tense. With the right attitude, having the right actions, having the ambitions, and having the right anticipation.
Mm.
We hope you've been blessed. We hope some of what we've said, if not all, you can take and let it be useful to you so that wherever we're falling short, and guess what? All of us fall short. Whatever it is you falling short and need a tune-up, we hope that you're using these nuggets to help you in that effort. Again, we're so grateful for you all hanging in with us, tearing with us, and really diving into the Word of God with us.
Praise the Lord. Again,
Kokoi
Nut, we have been enlightened. Kukui Nut. We have been protected.
Yes.
Of course, we are being guided by the Holy Spirit.
And
as long as we stay there, we'll keep the peace.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So again, we're going to be on track again for Sunday school on Saturday. Sunday school on the go. So please meet us at 10 o'clock by way of a Zoom platform. Yes. And on this Sunday, we're going to have... our ushers, appreciation and recognizing our ushers in memory of Brother James Bro, who really was an awesome young man who we met on the track.
Yeah.
Met on the track and walked right in the church and, of course, and started never walking with God
back.
And like any. He just walked through his situation and gone on to heaven. And so we want to celebrate him and his family even as he's gone. We still remember him. So profoundly of what he did and how God used him. Our message for Sunday is your standing is not in vain. Standing
is not in vain.
Sister Brown, you're gonna love this one. I'm telling you.
I can't wait. I'm anticipating.
And we ain't stinking, y'all. Yes, praise the Lord. But hey, we love y'all. We love y'all. We mean it. And y'all know y'all can do something about it. Come on, show us some love.
You gonna close us out with prayer?
Yeah, I'm gonna close. I gotta see some love up there first. Let me see some love. Show us some love. Hallelujah. God, we love you and we honor you. We give you glory and praise, God. We thank you today for another blessed privilege you afford us, Lord God, to come and to fellowship with each other and to just to break the bread of life.
Amen.
God, thank you today, Lord God, just for just opening up the word of God to us, Lord God. And now, God, you're challenging us, Lord God, to begin to make some attitude adjustment, Lord God, to begin to let our will become your will, our desire to become your desire, Lord God. And we already know, God, even in our action, Lord, whatever we think is what we are acting on. And as we act, Lord God, it become our character, become our destiny. So, God, we pray that we begin to act in ways that are so pleasing to you, Lord God. And, God, whatever is not like you, God, give us
the power, Lord God,
to be able to resist it, to run from it, Lord God. I pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that we constantly remind ourselves that we are going to all have to stand before the judgment seat of Christ. And we have to give an account of our stewardship. So, God, you've given us time, talent, and treasure. I pray that we are good steward over it, Lord God. I pray blessing upon every family on tonight, Lord God. And while we are praying, Lord God, we just want to pray for those that who have been impacted by the storm that are in Florida, Lord God. We pray for those who are even now still being trapped, Lord God. We pray, Father, for those who are out, Lord God, trying to find the search and rescues and all that are trying to happen to bring this help those who are in a place where they can't help themselves. We pray for those who may have lost homes and different things. We pray for recovery, Lord God. We pray, Father God, for just even now, Lord God, that as we see our neighboring country hurting and hurt, Lord God, that we who are strong would bear the infirmity of the weak, Lord God, that we would do whatever we can, Lord God, not just in prayer, but whatever resources that we can to aid and help them out, Lord God. I pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that you continue to bless again everyone that is on fellowshipping with us. Lord God, I pray that we would truly become evangelists, that we will go, Lord God, if we found something good, Lord God, that we will go and share it with somebody else. God, we pray for the Holy Spirit, that, Lord God, that you would bring everything that we taught to their remembrance. We pray the blood of Jesus would seal it, and
we thank you
in the name of Jesus. It is our prayer tonight. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And thank God again. Thank you all. Blessings to you all. Mahola. Thank you. From Hawaii.
Mahola.
We're still on the
That simply means what?
Thank you.
So praise God. We esteem you.
Yes.
We respect you.
Yes.
And we honor you.
Hallelujah.
Mahola.
Y'all be blessed.
And blessed. Aloha. Goodbye.
Bye, y'all. Love you all. Oh, yeah. Y'all so kind. Blessings to you all. Remember, striving each and every day to stay in spiritual alignment.
Live in future tense. Forget about the past. Press on in the present and press on into your future. Can't do it without you.
Hallelujah.